Okay, so I've had it happen just as I'm sure you've had it happen as well, and it's not fun at all. And of course, what I'm talking about is losing a PowerPoint presentation file. Whether you don't save it or you delete it completely, today I'm going to be showing you how to recover said PowerPoint file and get your presentation back right now. So let's get started. So when you think about it, there's really only two scenarios that you could run into when you lose a file like this. So A, you could either lose it by losing progress on your PowerPoint or presentation simply by not saving since the last time you opened it, and then let's just say that PowerPoint suddenly crashes and then you lose all your progress. So that's one scenario. The second scenario would be you simply delete the file in and of itself. So the .ppt file that's created by PowerPoint whenever you save your presentation is completely gone. And luckily, I have one solution for each scenario that are typically pretty bulletproof. And so that's why I've structured this video the way that I have. It's essentially divided up into two main sections, where first I'm going to be showing you how to recover an unsaved PowerPoint, and then I'm going to show you how to recover a deleted PowerPoint. And I have a couple of points for each one. So we're going to be moving into the first one, and then I'll slowly transition into the second one and wrap up the whole video from there. So that means that in this video, you won't find your most basic tips like checking your recycle bin and things like that, but that doesn't mean that you shouldn't still do that. But I wanted to just get straight to the meat and potatoes and make sure that you guys have all the information that you need as quickly as possible. All right, so let's kick it all off with starting with method number one, and that is learning how to recover an unsaved PowerPoint presentation. So it turns out that Microsoft was actually thinking about us when they designed their software, and inside of every Microsoft 365 software inside the bundle, they included a safeguard in it that essentially prevents against situations exactly like this. Now, I should note that this method is predicated on something called auto recover being enabled before you lost all your progress. Now, typically with fresh versions of PowerPoint, auto recover is automatically enabled, but in order to check to see if it was enabled, all you need to do is head over to File, Options, and then under Save, you should see this box checked. And then if it is, then that means that auto recover has been enabled and that this method should work. So let's say you have a presentation. You have a PowerPoint presentation, everything's going fine, and then things freeze. They crash and they shut down, and you didn't have time to save, so now you just lost 3 hours of work. Well, a feature that they added, which is super handy, is usable simply just by reopening PowerPoint, and you'll see this button right here, which you can simply click, which will open the recovered version of that presentation using auto recover, which you can then save to solidify the changes. So now, typically when I include methods like this, I usually like to give a little bit more of a technical explanation so that you can actually troubleshoot the main method just in case it doesn't work. And so you can actually access the auto recover folder directly from Windows, and all you need to do is just paste this file path in the search bar, and I'll have it down below so you can copy it, and then you replace the username with your username of your computer, and then hit enter, and you'll be brought to a folder that should look something like this. Now all you have to do is click in this folder and copy the PowerPoint file to a safe location. Okay, now, if none of what I just said made any sense or worked for you in any capacity at all, then what you're probably dealing with is a deleted PowerPoint. So that means the actual file, the .ppt file, has been deleted. Now, none of what I just said applies to you in that case, but there is a very good method that you can use to recover that file, and it's essentially going to be using file recovery software to get that presentation back into our hands. Now, the thing about file recovery software, though, is that whenever you're dealing with a lost file, you want to try and minimize the amount of time that you're actually using the device that the deleted file is stored on. So in this case, I'm actually going to be recovering a presentation from just a typical USB stick. So if I were to delete this in real life, then I would actually stop using this USB stick until I have the ability to run a search using file recovery software on this drive before I do anything else. So if that's you, make sure you stick with me throughout this entire video all the way to the end to give you the best chance of recovering your presentation fully intact. So when I say file recovery software, what am I talking about? Well, the main piece of software that I've been using for a couple years now and that I talk about all the time is called Disk Drill. Disk Drill is insane. I've used it personally myself for a couple years, and that's for good reason. It's seriously one of the best in the industry. It's got all the power and flexibility that you need, and with Disk Drill 4 for Windows, you can recover up to 500 megabytes of files for free, which is more than enough for 100 PowerPoints. I'm going to include a link down below in the description where you can get started with Disk Drill from our website. But once you've downloaded and installed it, then go ahead and open it up. And at this point, once Disk Drill is open, go ahead and connect the drive that has your deleted PowerPoint on it to your computer. Now, once you get past all the intros and tutorials at the beginning of Disk Drill, you'll be brought to a main list of drives that are connected to your computer, which is something that we like to call the disk list. So at this point, with your USB stick or whatever drive that your PowerPoint is on connected to your computer, it should show up right in the middle here inside the disk list, at which point you can select it, select your scan method, and click Search for Lost Data. Okay, so I've just started my scan on my USB drive, and now I'm going to wait for the entire scan to finish, and I'll catch up to you once it's done. Okay, so the scan has finished, and now what we can do is review the files that were found by clicking this blue button right over here. And now you can review the files either in the middle, in the categories on the left, or in the search bar in the top right if you happen to know the file by name. So after a little bit of browsing, I found my deleted PowerPoint that I wanted to recover. And so at this point, all you need to do is select the file by putting a check mark next to it, then click Recover, and choose your save location. Now when you're recovering your PowerPoint, make sure that you export it to a location that's not the location that you're trying to recover from. So do not export it to your USB drive or your SD card or even your computer's main hard drive, whatever you're trying to recover from. Just export it to a different location, a different drive than you're trying to recover from. It's very important. And once all that is done and entered, click OK. And that will export the file to your saved location. And I can open it up and work on it just like it never left. All right, there we go. So we are back in business. All my fellow students and people that give PowerPoint presentations on the regular, I hope that this helped you out a lot and hopefully saved you a little bit of pain and panic. I know I wish I knew this back in college and high school when I was giving presentations on the regular. But either way, I hope this helped you. If it did, always be sure to leave us a like down below. And if it didn't, then leave us a comment and let us know how we can improve and let us know how we can help you. Always, you know, you can reach out to our help desk on our website. We always love hearing from you guys all the time, and I enjoy reading your comments all the time. But that is going to be it for this video. My name is Andrew, and until next time, thank you for watching.